The use of STMath puzzles to lead a whole group or small group short conversation is what we call puzzle talks. Puzzle talk lessons leverage the power of the visual models inherent in STMath, while the teacher uses facilitating questions to promote classroom discourse and enhance the learning experience. And these aren't just simple routines. Discussions can be extended over several days to continue to explore concepts, strategies, and ideas connected to the visual representation and mathematics in the STMath puzzles. Here's the suggested course of action for using puzzle talks. Number one, if puzzle talks are part of your remote learning plan, assigning pre-work encourages students to think about the concept before the actual puzzle talk lesson, enriching the learning experience for students. A pre-work sheet is provided in the puzzle talk extensions. Number two, the puzzle talk lesson itself includes look-fors, facilitating questions, and lesson directions. The goal of puzzle talks is to get students thinking about strategies and math concepts. It's important that the student drives the discussion. Number three, following the puzzle talk, teachers may want to continue learning through extension activities. These activities allow the puzzle talk to be extended throughout the week. These could be word problems, journal writing activities, exploring other puzzles, or hands-on activities designed to deepen student understanding and help students make connections. The extension activities are provided and can be used to support your remote learning plan. Facilitation and student discourse are keys to a successful puzzle talk experience. Encourage peer-to-peer and whole group conversations. By engaging students in rich discussions throughout the problem-solving process, teachers are providing an opportunity for students to apply, observe, analyze, and evaluate strategies. In puzzle talks, all the thinking is in the hands of the students, allowing them to develop identity and agency as mathematics thinkers.